this week's focus is on the pleasure points inside the vagina.
We've obviously heard about Jean's vagina workshops before this. This is the first time that we're actually seeing it. And that's such a spectacular prop. It's with a removable clitoris.
There were at least two or three spares, I think.
Wouldn't that be nice? You know, the analogy about will the bike be rusty if it hasn't been used is just fabulous.
Oh, yes, I was wondering, if your bike has been sitting in the garden for 6 years, it's probably going to be quite rusty, isn't it?
So this actress, Samantha Spiro, who plays Mrs. Groff, is so fantastic.
What I'm asking is, if you haven't been touched in a long time, are you still going to feel anything?
I can assure you, vaginal pleasure does not diminish with age or lack of contact.
You know, Jean's very patient, but I just love Samantha's reactions to the questions and the depth of shame that she feels around it. You know, it's just so palpable.
Before you hear Jakob putting up the shelf, you've had a previous scene in the episode where he's raised the idea, hasn't he, of putting up a shelf, and you said you don't need it.
Yeah.
Three more screws.
I'm sure many of us have had the feeling of being completely usurped by somebody's presence in the house, and that's certainly something that all couples have to negotiate to varying degrees in their lives, especially when they start to cohabitate.
Can you talk about the colander? Because I think we need to discuss it. The colander seemed to have a life of its own. Every take, it would go in a different direction and yeah. Sort of fly off, and it just would not behave.
It's the word colander, the fact that there's a colander in the scene.
The colander.
Jean, definitely having lived as a single parent with her son for a long time, I'm sure has dealt with this, but having to deal with it with a grown man is new again for her.
This isn't about pound shelves. Is it?
I love how reasonable Jakob is in that moment. He's so reasonable and he's so patient and he knows exactly what she's doing. Jean complaining about the amount of coins.
And why do you have so much loose change?
For women, the fact that men carry their coins in their pockets and very often put them onto surfaces or dirty socks or clothes being left everywhere, or whatever it is. Women in general might say that if they are cohabitating with a man, that there might be a different relationship to how one deals with one's clothes and where one sticks things. Oh, God, that was so much fun to play. Also because she's so worked up by it. And as he says, he's only got three more screws left, but that is just, it's a straw that has broken the relationship's back. And she also knows that that bit of information about having kissed her ex-husband will potentially be the end, that that is the thing, that it's not going to be about complaining about his shelf, and it's not going to be about the change, and it's not going to be about this, but that it's taking that action of kissing her ex, that that will be the end of it. And she regrets that. Going back into the room, you know, she's a professional therapist. She's meant to be the one who's leading the way in terms of calm and holistic behavior. And the fact that her clients have heard this diatribe is embarrassing. Clearly, this location was chosen for that view.
I was worried about this location just because it almost looks like it's not real.
Yeah.
Almost looks like green screen, but it is a real location.
Jean's come here. No, there are other people in her life that she could bring this to, and she's, you know, she's just at a point where she's properly missing him, and these are the kind of things that she'd normally be able to talk through with him. And she's enjoying hearing his input, and to the degree that she, you know, innocently asks if he wants to grab a bite to eat.
I'm afraid I can't do that, Jean.
It was one stupid kiss. You really can't forgive me.
I don't think for a second she imagines that he's going to say no, or that for one second he's going to say something that is such a dagger that she's not ready, which of course she really isn't. She so loves being on her own. I think she knows it, but to hear it from somebody else, of course, is always more painful. if it's a painful truth. And that's kind of what she's experiencing here. I don't think she has many people in her life other than Otis who call her on stuff, you know, who call her on her behavior.
You're not ready for the kind of intimacy I'm looking for.
You know, I think she's realized that she really liked this man.
Understood.
And rejection is painful for anybody.
Goodbye, Yako.
Yeah.
I was so pleased that we had a number of tracks that we were considering, and that Sufjan Stevens track, I think, is so evocative.
There was part of me that felt, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get there emotionally. And yet, which you do as an actor, you think, how can I use this frustration to help? Because otherwise I'm just going to get in my own way.
You did it in three takes, and each one brought something very interesting. I get really moved when I watch that scene.